Welcome to Deathmatch Combat Training. Deathmatch is a sport in which you compete against other gun-wielding players in a fast-paced free-for-all. The object is to destroy all of your enemies by any means necessary. Every time you take an enemy out, you get a point, called a frag, in gaming lingo. You can see your frag count on the left side of the screen. At the end of the game, the player with the most frags wins the match. Remember, if you accidentally blow yourself up, or fall into lava, you will lose a frag. Let's learn some basics about moving around. A good deathmatch player is always moving because a moving target is harder to hit than a stationary one. Use your controller to move around the arena. Now use your controller to look around and strafe. Another important element of moving around is jumping. Jumping allows you to reach areas of the map that are too high to walk to normally and to cross dangerous pits. Try pressing the jump button and jump around the map. Excellent. Let's learn about offense. Remember, the only way to win at deathmatch is to destroy your foes with weaponry that you collect. I'm going to open the weapons locker and allow access to some guns. Let's pick them up and get ready for some target practice. Great, now we're armed. The gun you're carrying is commonly called the shock rifle. It, like all other weapons in the tournament, has two firing modes. Let's try shooting the gun now. Press the fire button to emit a lethal electric beam. Very good. The shock rifle's primary fire will instantly hit the person you shoot at. In Unreal Tournament, every weapon also has an alternate firing mode. Press the Alt Fire button to shoot a ball of plasma at your enemy. Great! The Alt Fire on the shock rifle is slower moving than primary fire, but does more damage. It's up to you to decide which attack is right for the situation. Sometimes you might be carrying more than one weapon. I've just put an Enforcer sidearm in your pack. You can cycle through weapons easily on your controller. Let's change to the Enforcer now. Good, now you know how to switch weapons in battle. Every weapon in Unreal Tournament is a projectile weapon except one, the Impact Hammer. Let's change to the Impact Hammer now. The Impact Hammer is a melee or close combat weapon. It requires you to be standing very close to the target to do damage. The trade-off is that a hit will almost always kill your enemy. Press and hold the primary fire button now to charge up the Impact Hammer. Now run up to the gnarly I just spawned. When you get close enough, the Impact Hammer will release, blowing him into pieces. Look at those jibs fly. Great job. Good job. Now we're going to take out some stationary targets. Shoot all three barrels to proceed. Nice shooting, Tech. It's about to get harder. I'm going to release a training human opponent for you to practice on. You'll have to frag him 3 times to complete the tutorial. Good luck!
First blood!
Congratulations! You have proven yourself to be a worthy deathmatch player. Now it's time to enter the deathmatch tournament ladder. Welcome to Domination Combat Training. This tutorial will instruct you on the basic gameplay rules of domination. Tutorials on deathmatch, capture the flag, and assault are also available. Let's start by learning about the elements Domination adds to the heads-up display, or HUD. Domination enhances the basic team play HUD by adding control point status indicators to the left side of your screen. As you can see, there are 2 control points on this tutorial map. We'll discuss the function of control points shortly. Each indicator shows the name of a control point and that control point's current status. Every control point in a domination map has a unique name. These control points are named Alpha and Gamma. The icon next to the control point name displays the status of that location. Before I explain how these icons work, let's discuss the rules of domination. In domination, each team is trying to control and hold the level's control points. A team is given 1 point every 5 seconds for each location they control. This is a control point. The gray X symbol indicates that no team is in control of this location. To take control of a location, touch it. Do this now. Good, now your team controls this location. Notice that the shape and color of the control point has changed to reflect your team symbol and color. Look at the control point status icon. Notice that the gamma point icon has changed to indicate your team is in control. You can use these icons to quickly assess the state of a domination game. Now find and control the alpha point to secure your domination of this map. Excellent, you control all of the points on this map. In summary, each team must locate and capture certain points in a domination map. The more locations a team controls, the faster their score increases. This device is called a translocator. You can use it to teleport from one location to another instantly. Hit the fire button to launch the translocator destination module. The module is now on the floor. If you hit the Alt Fire button, you will be teleported to the module. Run away from the module and hit the Alt Fire button. Good, now you're back at the module. You can fire the module out, switch to a weapon, and switch back to the translocator to activate it anytime you want to. If you see an enemy translocator module on the ground, you can shoot it to disrupt it. Translocating to a disrupted module causes instant death. It's time for a test. I'm going to spawn 2 bots on the enemy team and 1 bot to assist you. The first team to gain 20 points wins. Good luck! Congratulations! You've proved yourself to be skilled at domination. Now it's time to enter the domination tournament ladder. Welcome to Capture the Flag combat training. Let's start by learning about the heads-up display, or the HUD. CTF adds a few new elements to the HUD you should be aware of. Your HUD color indicates your team affiliation. Your HUD is red, indicating you are on the red team. A blue HUD would indicate that you were on the blue team. The 2 flag icons indicate the status of the red and blue flags. Just to the left of each flag status icon is that team's score. Now let's look at the elements CTF adds to the scoreboard. The left column lists the red team players and scores, and the right column lists the blue team players and scores. Notice your name and current score of 0 listed to the left. Above your name is the name of your team. When a player in CTF is carrying the flag, a small dot will appear next to their name in the scoreboard. This can be used to quickly determine which teammate to protect or which enemy to hunt down. In Capture the Flag, you can use the translocator. It works the same way as in Domination, but with one minor change. You are not allowed to translocate and carry the flag at the same time. If you translocate while holding the enemy flag, you will successfully translocate, but the flag will have dropped on the ground. This prevents you from translocating all the way back to your base after you have captured the enemy flag. Each CTF map has a red and a blue base. This is red base. Blue base is just down the hallway. Each base contains a flag. In front of you is the red flag. The object of CTF is to capture the enemy team's flag while defending your own. Let's give it a try. Run to the blue base and touch their flag to pick it up. Grab any equipment you find along the way. Great, now you have the enemy flag. The flashing yellow message is to remind you that once you have the flag, you need to return it to your base to score. Notice the blue team flag status icon changed. Now it indicates that a red team player is in possession of the flag. Take the flag back to your base and touch the red flag to capture the blue flag and score. Great job! You captured the enemy flag and scored a point for your team. Wasn't so hard now, was it? It's about to get harder. In a few seconds, I'm going to spawn 2 blue team bots and a red teammate you can practice with. There's one last status icon to tell you about. If a player drops the flag while carrying it, his team's flag status icon will change to a flag icon containing a downward arrow. If you find your flag lying on the ground after you kill an enemy who is carrying it, touch it to automatically return it to your base. This concludes CTF tutorial. Let me spawn those practice bots for you. Good hunting!
First blood.
Congratulations! You've proven yourself a worthy CTF player. Now it's time to enter the Capture the Flag tournament ladder. Welcome to Assault Combat Training. This tutorial will instruct you on the basic rules of assault. Tutorials on Deathmatch, Domination, and Capture the Flag are also available. The first thing you'll notice upon entering an assault game is the large digital time display to the left of your HUD. This timer counts away the seconds until the game ends. Time is critical in an assault game.
The game consists of two teams, each with a unique goal. You are on the attacking team. Your job is to penetrate the enemy base and destroy several key locations. If you fail to take the enemy base within the allotted time, you lose. The opposing team are the defenders. The defenders' job is to protect their base and key locations from the assaulting team. If you succeed in taking the enemy base as an attacker, then you must play the role of the defender for the same length of time. Each assault map is unique in design. It may take time to learn the layout and develop strategies to attack or defend successfully. Some explosive has been set on the cave wall near the enemy base. Use your weapon to light the fuse, then get back. Use the breach the explosive creates to enter the enemy base and take out the tank. Congratulations! You succeeded in destroying the plasma tank. Now it's time to enter the assault tournament ladder.